Hey everybody, welcome back. This lesson is about the kV and mA waveforms on radiographic imaging devices. First, let's talk about the kilovoltage. The kilovoltage, abbreviated kV or kVp, is the X-ray tube potential. The kVp controls the X-ray beam energy, the X-ray photon frequency, and the wavelength of each photon in the X-ray beam. For example, if we increase the kVp, this results in an increased photon energy, increased photon frequency, and decreased photon wavelength. The opposite is also true. If we decrease the kVp, this results in a decreased photon energy, decreased photon frequency, and an increase in the wavelength of photons. The milliamperage, or mA, is a different exposure factor that refers to the tube current. This factor controls the number of photons in the X-ray beam, and the relationship is directly proportional. For example, if we increase the mA, this results in an increase in the number of photons, that's the photon quantity, but there's no change in the photon energy. The opposite is also true. If we decrease the mA, this results in a decrease in the number of photons, that's the photon quantity, but there's still no change in the photon energy. So how do we know that the X-ray machine is actually generating the selected technical parameters during the exposure? One way is to measure the kV and mA waveforms. These waveforms are visual representations of the actual mA and kVp applied to the X-ray system during the exposure. When operating correctly, both the kV and mA waveforms should be stable and flat during the entire exposure. This is important to ensure the correct X-ray output, the correct X-ray energy, optimal image quality, and optimal patient dose. Each of these waveforms looks unique. A perfect kV waveform generates the selected kV from the very beginning to the very end of the exposure. This is considered a flat waveform. For example, if the exposure is set to 30 kV, the system should generate exactly 30 kV for the entire exposure. However, if the exposure is set to 40 kV, the system should generate exactly 40 kV for the entire exposure. If the generator system was not installed or serviced correctly, the kV waveform might include an overshoot or undershoot, meaning that at the beginning of the exposure, it's not generating the assigned kV input. Notice in these examples that the generator will correct itself along the way, and when it reaches the correct value, it will maintain that kV until the end of the exposure. An incorrect kV waveform must be corrected. The kV waveform at the generator affects the kV output at the tube. To fix this, we start by making sure the kV waveform is flat. Next, adjust the output kV to match the assigned kV. Finally, recheck the kV waveform and adjust as needed. Continue back and forth until both the waveform and the output are correct. Incorrect waveforms can result in several adverse effects, including various image quality issues like saturation or model, but also excessive patient dose and generator faults. The mA waveform is slightly different from the kV waveform. The mA waveform starts with a current spike before normalizing to the assigned mA. This is called the rotor spike. When the exposure is initiated, power is also supplied to the anode assembly to make the rotor spin. This spike is completely normal. After this rotor spike, the rotor is immediately braked to the correct RPMs and the actual X-ray exposure begins. After this rotor spike, the mA waveform should then be completely flat through the end of the exposure. After the kV waveform is calibrated, the mA waveform must be calibrated for every mA station on every kV setting. Also, the mA waveform must be regularly updated as the tube ages to ensure accurate and optimal system performance. This is because the X-ray tube properties can change over time. Just like kV, incorrect mA waveforms can result in several adverse effects, including image quality issues, unnecessary patient dose, and generator faults. So in summary, both the MA and kV waveform should be flat for the full length of the actual exposure. And this is important to ensure correct X-ray output, correct X-ray energy, optimal image quality, and optimal patient dose. If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.